Hello, wifeys. It's Barefaced Michaela here, and we are about to embark on some new makeup. To me, some of it's new releases, like the Rare Beauty, and some of it's just new to me. So it's not like new on the market. I've just never tried it, and I wanted to try it because I don't try every new thing that comes out. You know, I'd be broke. So if you want to see what I'm trying out today, then just keep on watching. Let's get started. Okay, so I guess I need to not have a bang. Let's just go this way with it, because we're gonna start with the Give Beauty eyebrow pencil. I bought this at TJ Maxx for $8.99, and I have the shade number 4. There's the pencil coming out. I thought it was so strange because of like the shape of this, the little wand thing. That was strange, but I want to spray my face. Some days when I just can't be bothered to prime, just use the Fix Plus or these little waters from Mario Badescu. Okay, my brow hair's up. I'm sorry if I'm looking down, but I should put my mirror in front so y'all could at least see the good angle. All right, let's go in with the Give Beauty Most Def Instant Definition Sculpting Brow Pencil. I don't know how I'm supposed to hold it. Like, feels natural to hold it like this, but I feel like the packaging is kind of getting in the way. Let's flip it. Maybe it's more like this. It just feels strange to not be able to see the product, but it's working. That's a nice brow. That's a nice brow. Do the other one with it flipped down on the bottom. I just feel like I can't see my line. Okay. I think I got it. It's waxy. Like it has pull, if you get what I'm saying. Like it's not like gliding, it's like tugging, which I don't like how thick my brows are. I don't know if that's because of me or I don't know. I don't like thick brows anymore. But I mean, it's nice. Like, I feel like I would like it in like a traditional pencil, but I'm gonna use it and it's fine. It's just strange. I'm gonna carve my brows out and then I'll be right back. It's giving hairy monster. But luckily, my hair will camouflage that. Okay, now we need to get into, I think I wanna do the Rare Beauty. What is this called? Here it is, and it is called the Positive Light Under Eye Brightener. I have it in the shade medium tan. And it looks like this. And right here on the box, it says this is a weightless brightening liquid formula that illuminates and refreshes the under eye area with a natural luminous finish. It's not giving concealer. I know a lot of girls on YouTube think that it's concealer. Look at that wand. You don't see that? It's like metal. So yeah, it's giving like, oh, it's cool. I like that. Well, you can't even get that much product out on it. So yeah, it's definitely not, it's like one of those, it's an eye brightener. It's like, I'm thinking it's for like no makeup, makeup days. I'm gonna go in with my finger because, yeah. Wow. Do we see the brightness? Like if you can see underneath the dots, this is how my eye is looking before. And this is after. Yes, it's giving a tinted moisturizer and eye brightener. It's not canceling out all my darkness. Cause I mean, I got a newborn, so I need this and a prayer, okay? Yeah, that's more like it. I need a little bit more out and like, look at it. Ooh, I love this. I love this. My baby waking up. So I'll probably be back in like an hour, but it'll be like 1 second for y'all. Well, let's blend it out before I go feed her. I love the finish. This is beautiful. Love this. Say hi to the people. Say hi to the people. As I was saying, look at my under eye. Like, I don't look sleep deprived. I look moisturized. I love this. This is gonna go really well. You want to be on the go, you want to get out the house quick, but just want to look a little put together. Get this one for sure. I have a baby in here with me. Next, let's get into, let me look at everything I got to try. I only have a few things to try. So, and plus, I think this will be a good like color corrector type deal. You see? Like just to do underneath your concealer so that it's not trying to work double hard. But like, let's get into the Bare With Me blur blurring tint foundation. Like they name this kind of crazy. Did I bring my sponge in here? I was like, I could have sworn I with a sponge. Okay, I have the shade Deep Bronze. There's no. This is a matte, medium coverage matte blurred finish. Ooh, matte. I haven't done matte in forever. I'm glad we didn't prime like too much. That might be too much. I got that much on a sponge. This might be too dark for me. Oh no, it looks good. My sponge is not like wet enough. It's bothering me. She's just like on her play mat right now, playing on the floor. And then in a few minutes, I'm gonna flip her over. I love this. I'm gonna flip her over on her tummy. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. It's such a stark difference because I already carved out my brows. So, what do we think? Am I matte? Definitely medium coverage, kind of full. But you can still see some of my blemishes over here. And over here. It's comfortable, it's light, it's not heavy. It's not drying. I don't know if this is a matte finish. It's kind of, we're gonna let it sit down. Yeah, we're gonna let it sit down because it's giving satin finish. But I don't know. We might be matte. Do I look matte to y'all in front of the lights? Do I look matte? Do I look matte? I'm not sure. I'm not so sure. Now we're gonna go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is the Magic Touch Concealer in the shade 16. Looks like this. Cute packaging. Very large tube. I hope this isn't too light. Like, I'm trying to come back down to earth with my concealer shades. Yeah, this is more my speed. I know it still probably looks a little light, but it's gotta be. That's so creamy. That's so creamy. I like that. Ooh. What you doing, Mama? Yeah. My under eye is beautiful. Like, look at that. So smooth, so creamy. This is beautiful finish. Now she's getting older, like she's staying awake after she eats. Like she eats and like she likes to play now and look at stuff. She's going to be my baby. This is beautiful. This is a beautiful base. Like, this is a beautiful base. I'm going to go off camera, or do y'all just want me to do it here? I'm gonna go off camera. All right, I am back. I did the Rare Beauty Hope blush, and I did my Chanel cream bronzer, so that's done. Now let's get into the One Size powder in the shade Translucent. I've heard great things. All the girls are raving. This is how it looks. Cute packaging. It comes with a little sticker in there. This is the mini size because, y'all, I'm still going through my Laura Mercier and Fenty powder. Like, I'm not buying another full size translucent powder for years. Like, I can't get through that. And I use it every single time, one or the other. And they're still not even close to being empty. I need tweezers. I miss having nails. But they're not good for my baby. Boom. I'm gonna put some in the cap. I hope that works. No. There it is, I suppose. I don't know if that's enough. Okay. Well, this is a fine powder. I'm gonna go in. Should we use our new brushes? I bought these brushes from TJ Maxx. And I think we could do this one as an under eye powder brush, right? By Kala Beauty Eco Natural Face Sculpting Set. Now I think I want to use this one with the one size powder. It's a little dense, but it's pretty. Let's just try it. Not that much powder on there. Bless you, babe. Bless you. Oh my goodness. Wow, that is pretty. That's very smoothing. I think I got a dry patch right here. Ooh, I look airbrushed. This is pretty. Maybe if I had the full size, I'd be able to get my like sponge in the top, but I don't. I don't have full size, and I'm not buying full size. Why are you looking at the bunny like that? He's scaring you. Yeah, I'm not 2 months old in there watching PBS Kids. Like, why is she so ahead? I'm obsessed with the way my face looks. Like, I low-key want to set my whole face with this because it looks so good. Do we have, we don't have any more. Oh yeah, we do. We're gonna do our subculture. Oh, and it looks like this, and I think we're gonna do like a goldy warm type of look. So let's just get a brush. And I'm gonna go in with New Wave. I think the most I've done is like swatch this. My eyes are creasing. Wouldn't do that with the Mario, Makeup by Mario. It's just like a mustardy, well, a really golden tan. Now I'm gonna go in with Roxy right here. And now let's go in with Fudge. Okay, and then let's go in with Adorn right here. This is gonna be pretty. Yep. Look at that. Oh, it's so like soft, like to touch. Why do I always get a palette like this? Look at all these colors, and then I just make a soft glam look. It's like what is wrong with me? On like this matte tan shade right here. See how that looks. Yeah, that's good enough. Shall we set our whole face using the one size powder? Because I'm just really curious to see how that looks. Like, I wanna use that all over my face. Making a mess. Really, I just wanna use like to set everything. it just like makes everything so airbrushed looking. Like, it just makes my face look so smooth. Am I tripping? I feel like I look so smooth. All right, I'm gonna go finish mascara and everything else off camera in my lip, and I'll be back to do a recap. I don't know if y'all heard, but Matt is back. Okay, Matt is back. My face is giving me when I first had the twins 5-7 years ago. You know what I'm saying? Very 2013, 2014 matte everything, but with the soft glam aesthetic. I'm not putting shadow underneath my eyes anymore because I feel like it closes my eyes up. Like, I already have so much happening. Let's do a recap, shall we? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. If you're a mom on the go, if you're a mom, you're on the go. So every day we can't do this. Every day this cannot be achieved. You know what I'm saying? Emergencies. Yes, I can't wait to like do this with this, y'all. This Tarte Maracuja Hydrator Tinted Moisturizer. These about to be a go-to. She can hear me talking. And when she hears me talking, she squirms. She's asleep. She's literally like whining with her eyes closed. But anyways, I can't be helped. Love that. Get this. This is beautiful. It sets down beautifully. I don't know if it's matte. It seems satin, but if you set it with like a powder, it's matte. Like, my face is very much matte. Like, this is manufactured glow. I put some of the Hourglass highlighter right there, powder highlighter. But this is nice. This is really nice. It was affordable. Got it at the drugstore side of Ulta. I enjoyed that. This is beautiful. It's beautiful. I just love me a creamy concealer that just smooths everything out. Smooths everything out. Makes everything look nice and plump and just, well, I drink water. I drink water. This is good. And this is a lot. And the shade is beautiful. Beautiful shade. When I do empty one of my powders, I feel like I'm gonna empty this first. And if I empty this, I'm getting a full size because this, and it didn't like make it turn white. Like, I don't know. Like, I wouldn't consider this a highlighting powder. Like, if you're gonna highlight, you better do it with your concealer, because like, I don't feel like it added any type of brightness or anything like that. And I got the translucent shade. I just feel like it's just smooth, airbrushed. I love this. And this is just the ultimate setting powder. It's set. It looks really, really good. I really enjoyed this. And what else did I try? Yo, these brushes were good. They're nice and soft for like a TJ Maxx find. It's still some one size powder on here, I feel. I'm not wasting it. I'm using all of it. Because it's too pretty. It's too pretty to waste it. I don't really expect anybody to get rid of my smile line. It's not even like concealer or powder. I have a big mouth. I'm always smiling, so it is what it is. Like, you can't be my savior. Like, Jesus saves. Okay, setting powder, it sits. It doesn't save. But anyways, oh, Soap Culture. This was pretty. I mean, I just love Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow formulas. It's one of my favorite companies that make eyeshadow palettes. They make some of my favorite makeup products, I'm not gonna lie. So I kind of feel like the concealer was gonna be a great. I can't wait to try it with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Luminous foundation that I love from them. They make one of my favorite foundations. Here it is. This one, this is a good one, y'all. Y'all see, like, I use the heck out of this. So I feel like these are gonna go good together. So I can't wait to try those. But yeah, that was me trying new makeup. Oh, it made my brows thicker than I would like, but you can't see my brows hardly. So maybe I do need to have them a little thick so you can see them, but I don't know. I like the formula because I like for my pencils to have like a little tug. I don't like them to just glide and just deposit a lot of color. I like for it to kind of like tug through the brow hairs. But I don't like the shape. That's the only thing. Like if this was in a regular pencil form, I wouldn't have any, you know, quips. Because I feel like I would have more control. But like with this awkward pencil shape, like it's just, I feel like I don't have that much control, and that like whatever is getting on there is gonna get on there, and I gotta work with what I have. So that is all I have for today. We tried some new makeup, some new stuff and some new to me stuff. Do y'all like how my face turned out? It's 2023. I feel like we've been living in the glowy aesthetic, very clean girl. I have a feeling that 2023, this is coming back. The matte skin, the, you know what I'm saying? The airbrush face, I feel like that's coming back. We're no longer in the skin that we're in. That's what it's giving with these makeup products, because NARS came out with a powder. Somebody else came out with a powder. It's giving year of the matte. That's what it's giving. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys this Sunday for a weekend vlog. Bye.